Hello, adventurers, travelers, and friends, and welcome to another Bragworthy Adventures video. Today I am at Epcot, I'm at Disney World,
and I've got
my perfect Disney day pack, and I want to tell you what you should bring to Disney. The things that I always bring that I always find useful, and I'll show you some of the things I use throughout the day so you can see what actually I use and what I keep just in case. But I like to use this really small, adorable Disney backpack because it actually fits a lot more than you think. The only thing that I haven't figured out how to get fit in here is my water bottle, but it's a 40-ounce water bottle, so it's kind of huge. But I thought this would be useful for you guys who come. You really liked my walking shoes video, and just, you know, I'm wearing my Tevas today. I love my Tevas for walking shoes. But for what I bring to the park, I thought I would just kind of give you a little glimpse. And that way when you go to Disney, you have everything you need. Okay, so let's start with the knick-knack paddywhacks right up in the front pocket. I've got chapstick, because nobody likes crusty lips. A hairband. Just in case, I always keep a hairband with me. Two different types of drugs, even though they look like they're the same type. One is ibuprofen and one's actually Dramamine. Earphones, in case I don't want to talk to my family. Kleenex. That's, you know, I like to have that with me always too. And cough medication. Now in the other part of the bag, we've got sunglasses. These are my adorable pink ones. I've got a sweatshirt, and it feels like a Mary Poppins bag when I pull that out. It's huge, but it's my Disney Jersey sweatshirt, which I love for the parks. It's super comfy. It's one of my favorites. Clearly, I'm doing a great job of showing you what it looks like. It's totally in frame. I got a hairbrush because I have long hair, and it gets tangled easily. This is a backup charger. Your phone will die quicker at the parks than anywhere else, and I'm not exactly sure why that is, but it's true. We have my wallet, and you can see my tickets in there so that I could get into the park. That's actually my annual pass. This is a hand sanitizer spray. It's like all natural lavender and whatnot. And then we've got a poncho because I hate rain more than I hate almost anything, and I don't want the rain to touch me. So we got this back in Hurricane Irma, and I still have it. Okay, so already I'm taking out the sweatshirt because it's chilly today, and then I didn't have these in the backpack because I was wearing them, but I'll probably put them back in the backpack right now. And while we ate, I pulled out my hand sanitizer to keep my hands clean.
It's time for me to pull out the poncho.
This is why I always bring it, because you never know when it's going to start raining. Well, I mean, the weather kind of helps, but said it wasn't going to rain today, and it is! I also was not aware I would get a headache, but I did, so good thing I have my ibuprofen stored away in a Dramamine bottle. I think they're the best bottles for storing pills, but it can get confusing when I don't know which is which. I did show you some of the things I used in the park, and I forgot a couple of things that I did use in the park, I just forgot to film. Like that hairbrush I showed you, I did comb my hair out. It was a really windy day, and my hair was just getting tangled, and so I used that brush. I also don't think I ever showed you my water bottle. Like I mentioned, it didn't fit in my bag, but I kept it in my sister's stroller, and I definitely used this multiple times at the park. As much as Disney is magical, their water is not, so the bottled water tastes better, or you can bring those flavor packets, make your water into lemonade or whatever, so you can make it a little tastier. But you're definitely gonna need water in the parks, and I drink it even though it tastes bad. Now, I wanna go over what some of the other things you're gonna find online that people say you should pack and tell you why I don't pack them. Or let you know why maybe you might wanna pack them if that's something that you might need. So when I was doing research, some of the things I noticed was people mentioned bringing empty Ziploc bags. Their reason for bringing an empty Ziploc bag is your items may get wet. My reason for not bringing an empty Ziploc bag is, number one, the backpack that I like to use, my cute little Disney backpack, it's waterproof. So, I mean, if I have my items in here, they shouldn't get wet anyways. Also, Disney's pretty smart. Disney knows which rides will get you wet. There's two rides that'll really soak ya. That's Cali River Rapids in Animal Kingdom and Splash Mountain at Magic Kingdom. And Disney provides ways for you to make sure your very valuable items don't get wet. At Cali River Rapids, there are free lockers that you have to put your items in before getting in line for the ride. And at Splash Mountain, they provide you Ziplocs. They give you these cute little zippity-doo-dah Ziploc bags to put your items in. So, I mean, it's not a super necessity to bring an empty Ziploc to the park, but if you want to be extra safe, sometimes I bring empty Ziplocs. I didn't that day. I don't think it's a huge deal if you have it or don't have it. Next thing I saw that some people posted were quarters and pennies. If you like those like machines where you pull your penny out and it gets printed with a new thing, absolutely bring quarters and pennies. I bring my smaller wallet to Disney because I don't like the extra weight. The next thing that I see people bring is autograph books. I actually have my own. See this cute little one? This is based off of the Junior Encyclopedia of Animated Characters. And I did it because it has little things and sometimes the characters are interactive. Like this is when we met with Anastasia and Drusilla. And they even made some markings in there, which I just thought was fun. But if you can't tell, it's kind of big. And so unless I know I'm going to be going there for characters, I don't bring it. If you have one of the smaller ones and you can stash it easy, yeah, bring it. The next thing I noticed some other people were saying to bring that I didn't have in my bag was bug repellent. I usually am a bug magnet. Like, I go out and normal people are like, oh, I got a mosquito bite. And I'm like, I got 15.
Here is photo evidence of the many bug bites I get. This was after one day in a park in Berlin. Aren't I a lucky girl?
But I don't feel like there's as many bugs in the parks as there are outside the parks in other parts of Florida. So if you feel like you need to bring it, sure. I would definitely say if you're gonna bring bug spray, bring the wipes. So that's a little lighter than some liquid container. But I don't think you need it personally. Also, people said to bring a blanket to sit on, like for the shows or I don't know. I don't really see a reason to bring a blanket. If you already have a poncho like I do and a sweatshirt, then if it's really sunny out, then you can sit on your poncho on the grass and you don't need another item in there. Also, there's not that many grassy areas to sit in Disney. They have a lot of tables and they have benches. They make places for you to sit, so there's not a lot of like sort of picnic-y-ness. There's some, but I just don't think there's enough for you to need a blanket with you. Snacks? I think it's awesome that Disney lets you bring food into the parks because food there can be expensive. And so if you are trying to save on money and see Disney, bring snacks. It'll help you get through the day. And sometimes I do that, but the day that you saw me with my bag, I was going to Epcot, and I think many of us know Epcot has a lot of good food. So I didn't want to bring snacks because I knew I was just going to get food there. The next thing people said to bring that I don't bring is gum.
I don't want to burst your bubble, but there is not gum sold at Disney. So if you want gum, you better bring your own. And here is my evidentiary support, which I got from the internet, a very trustworthy place.
So if you're a chewer, I guess bring your own gum because you're not really going to find it there. But I don't chew gum, so I didn't need it. The next thing that a lot of people said were bubbles, glow items, and coloring books. You may have realized, or maybe this is your very first video, but I don't have kids, so I don't really need that. I mean, I guess I could bring a coloring book for me if I wanted, but I think that's more intended for children. But you know your kids. You know what they need. I would say if you do have kids, bubbles and glow items are things they're gonna see at the park that they may want to buy. So if you're there trying to save money, sure, bring that. But I don't have kids, so I only have to worry about my husband and what he might try and buy, and he's more frugal than I am, so it's not much of a worry. Also, don't forget there are some things you can't bring. So if you're packing right now and you're getting your stuff all together,
then you might want to check out Disney's website where they tell you what is prohibited from being brought into the parks. I would list them out, but apparently these can change at any time depending on what Disney decides. So probably better to check the website.
So I hope this helps you eliminate those extra things that you might not need so you can have the perfect Disney day pack, light, carefree, but still the essentials provided. And I hope you have a magical time at Disney. As always, bye travelers.